The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us now recall the presence of our God. Good morning, and welcome to this time of worship at the Congregational Church, United Church of Christ in Tryon. No matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, whether you have come brave or fearful, sad or happy, full of belief or questioning, lost or found, you are most welcome here in this home of Christ, friends, where we worship the God who welcomes us all. Today marks the beginning of Eastertide, and it is an opportunity for us, particularly this year, to reflect on what it must have been like for those early disciples, that in the wake of the Easter week, in the wake of finding the tomb with the stone rolled away, they knew what it was like to hope and to pray for new life in the midst of isolation and fear. So we give thanks that Christ is risen and that we can worship and that hope abounds and that death does not get the final word. And so as we worship together this morning, practicing physical distancing and social solidarity, as we worship to be the church in the world, we invite you from wherever you are joining us to fully participate in the prayers and songs as we praise God together. If you haven't already done so, you can find a link to our Sunday bulletin in the daily e-blast, but we will also be projecting all the words for our worship on our screen today. You can also find announcements about our life and ministry together in our daily e-blasts as well as the bulletin, so I invite you to take some time to look at those and see how you might be called to share in our collective ministry and grow in faith. There are many opportunities to participate in virtual church gatherings as well as serve our community. And today is one of those days. It is Church Beyond the Wall Sunday, and we'll talk a little bit more about that later in the service. But we are excited to go and be the church together, even as we worship apart. And so now, friends, as we worship this morning in a way that will continue far beyond this day and these walls, let us remember to be the church. Protect the environment, care for the poor, forgive often, reject racism, fight for the powerless, share earthly and spiritual resources, embrace diversity, love God, and enjoy this life. Will you please now join us in our call to worship?
We are glad to gather as your people, loving God, ready to worship, longing to love, willing to work your will through our lives. Sitting in worship, we wait in expectation. The Spirit will come as God has promised. We pray as we gather that we hear and heed your word, ready to change as you show us to grow into more faithful followers of Jesus. To the timid and the bold, and to all God's children, the Spirit will come as God has promised. We are glad to gather for worship and then to scatter for service, fortified in faith, nourished in fellowship, sustained by your Spirit. As we worship now in prayer and praise, the Spirit will come as God has promised.
And now may the peace of the resurrected Jesus, the challenging peace of committed life, the liberating peace of selfless love, the vibrant peace of new possibility, recall you to radical living, empower you for rich loving, and transform you with radiant joy. As a sign and love and hope of this Easter season, we share the peace and joy of Christ with one another. So take a moment now to share that peace with the person beside you. Send a text to a friend or loved one, a word of kindness and hope. Pray for your secret pen pal, whatever it may be. Share the peace of Christ with one another. So may that peace be with all of you.
In full of their joy.
pray. We praise you, God, for your timing. When we miss boats and chances pass us by and opportunities go begging, you get it right. You always do. Never failing to offer hope and strength and purpose for our days. We praise you, God, for your timing. When we rush around as if there is no tomorrow, fearing the future unless the present is jam-packed with meaningful activity, you get it right. You always do. Breathing space and peace into our flustered floundering. We praise you, God, for your timing. When we find days all too heavy on our hands and hearts, you get it right. You always do. Reminding us we are never alone in anything we face. God in community, holy in one, hear us as we pray together, as Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Hearing the story, Acts chapter 1, verses 1 through 14. The Act of the Apostles is the second significant act in Luke's account of the dramatic mission of God, which began with the incarnation of Jesus Christ. In these opening sentences of the book of Acts, the author lays out the direction the narrative will take, as the apostles take up the mantle of Jesus, empowered by the Holy Spirit, and speak the good news of God throughout the world. Now may the Spirit of truth open to us the scriptures, speaking a holy word, meeting us in the living God. Theophilus, the first scroll I wrote concerned everything Jesus did and taught from the beginning, right up to the day when he was taken up into heaven. Before he was taken up, working in the power of the Holy Spirit, Jesus instructed the apostles he had chosen. After his suffering, he showed them that he was alive with many convincing proofs. He appeared to them over a period of 40 days, speaking to them about God's kingdom. While they were eating together, he ordered them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait for what the Father had promised. He said, "This is what you heard from me. John baptized with water, but in only a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit." As a result, those who had gathered together asked Jesus, "Lord, are you going to restore the kingdom to Israel now?" Jesus replied, "It isn't for you to know the times or seasons that the Father has set by his own authority. Rather, you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witness in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the end of the earth." After Jesus said these things, as they were watching, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. While he was going away, and as they were staring toward heaven, suddenly two men in white robes stood next to them. They said, "Galileans, why are you standing here, looking toward heaven? This Jesus who was taken up from you into heaven will come in the same way that you saw him go into heaven." Then they returned to Jerusalem from the Mount of Olives, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey away. When they entered the city, they went to the upstairs room where they were staying. Peter, John, James, and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James, Alphaeus' son, Simon the Zealot, and Judas, James's son, all were united in their devotion to prayer, along with some women, including Mary, the mother of Jesus, and his brothers. For the word of God in Scripture, for the word of God among us, for the word of God within us. Thanks be to God.
Will you please pray with me? Gracious and loving God, as we enter this time of meditation, may you gather our hearts together, that in our isolation, we may still follow you and hear your Holy Spirit breaking through, guiding us out into the world. May your Holy Spirit dwell and rest among us in this time of holy waiting. All this we pray in Christ's name. Amen. We began the season of Eastertide on Easter Sunday with the proclamation that Jesus Christ is risen indeed, that death does not get the final word, but that love and hope abound. We moved from the wilderness of Lent, that 40-day period of repentance and reorienting ourselves toward God, to a different type of wilderness. Eastertide is a 50-day period. It starts on Easter and it ends on Pentecost. It's a new type of wilderness, a 50-day long single celebration as we prayerfully listen for the Holy Spirit's guidance, as we reflect on what it means to live in a world where resurrection exists, where the kingdom of God is at hand. And so we look to the stories of the early church for guidance. We look for that moment where the apostles gathered, those times when the Holy Spirit moved. We look at what that original period of waiting was like as Jesus spent time with the disciples before his ascension. The book of Acts begins by letting us know that the time after the stone had been rolled away and death defeated, Jesus kept appearing to the disciples to show that he was alive, but perhaps more importantly, to keep teaching about the kingdom. Much like those who feel that they have waited for a long time and are growing impatient, the disciples ask from the back of the car, "Are we there yet? Is the kingdom going to come now?" But that's not for them to know. It's not for us to know. And while waiting can be one of the most infuriating things, emotionally and physically taxing, sometimes waiting has its gifts. Because they wait knowing that they aren't in the business of prediction and that the Holy Spirit is coming. Also, as Will Willimon points out, one does not write church history if one expects the world to end tomorrow. And so the very writing of the book of Acts signals that we can relax our expectation about the imminent return of Christ and live into the present moment. Instead, living into this season of Eastertide. Now that the resurrection has come and gone, we get to spend some time with the question that remains. Now what? In the case of the disciples, they follow directions. They stop looking towards the heavens, willing a quick fix. And instead, they go back to Jerusalem as requested. They follow, understanding finally that Jesus has gone ahead. They go back to Jerusalem where they are called to be witnesses. From there, they will go to the end of the earth. And so they begin that time of growing that circle of ever-expanding good news. In these moments of teaching and witnessing, as they go back to Jerusalem, as they wait, as they listen to Jesus' kingdom's teachings, they begin to realize that through the Holy Spirit, Christ is present in all of creation. That Jesus isn't on a break. But when the question is asked, now what? The answer is, now is the kingdom. Go. Witness, build, listen for the Holy Spirit, pray, and be the good news with me. That original time of waiting, it was essential. Their work was going to be so important, but first they had to go back to Jerusalem and wait. That time of waiting allowed them to soak everything in prayer. It certainly wasn't about making decisions slowly, just waiting, about getting caught up in the church bureaucracy. That has never been what discernment is about. And it's certainly not an excuse for us to move slowly in responding to God. But that holy pause, that gift of breath and prayer and waiting, it was a reminder to them and all of us in each generation to focus on God and pray so that the major decisions are done deliberately and intentionally. God waits so that we might learn or begin to learn that we are to be a responsive community to God's initiation. And so if the resurrection is victory over death, ascension is empowerment. It is that period of waiting, that period of realizing who we are, that Christ is present, that the kingdom is now, that empowers us to connect to God, to go and be disciples, strengthened and ready to go out and live the good news. Like those first disciples, we find ourselves in a period of waiting right now, waiting for things to get back to normal, waiting for stay-at-home orders to be lifted. Some are growing impatient, denying that there was ever a need for social distancing, protesting en masse, wanting to travel to their vacation homes. They're done with being cooped up. But we would do well to look towards God in these moments, to embrace this time of waiting, to prepare for the important work ahead, like those first disciples, to look towards what it will truly mean to love our neighbors. Because the reality is we should probably never go back to normal. As Sonia Renee Taylor wrote, we will not go back to normal. Normal never was. Our pre-corona existence was not normal other than we normalized greed, inequity, exhaustion, depletion, extraction, disconnection, confusion, rage, hoarding, hate, and lack. We should not long to return to normal, my friends. We are being given an opportunity to stitch a new garment, one that fits all of humanity and nature. We are being given that opportunity to stitch that new garment, to in this time of waiting for the good of the whole, reflect on the inequities, on why some are so disproportionately hurt by stay-at-home orders, to build a kingdom in response where all are paid justly and have enough resources to feed and clothe and take care of their families' needs. To build a kingdom where homes are safe, where healthy, loving relationships are equitable, where the justice system believes the victim and actually protects them against their abuser so they are not stuck at home with them, and reports of domestic violence go down to nothing rather than spike. To build a kingdom where all are seen as essential. The Holy Spirit is present. The kingdom of God is at hand. The kingdom will be kind, compassionate, and just. The kingdom may grow more slowly than we would like, as the fruit takes time to develop both in the messenger and also the seed that matures in the hearer. But the kingdom has begun. And as Edward Pillar wrote, while the specific shape of the kingdom is not predetermined, it will grow organically as disciples, then and now, wait upon God, pray, and respond to the prompting of the Holy Spirit, to live with love, kindness, and mercy, always looking towards justice and peace, to emerge as beautiful fruit of the kingdom of Jesus. The Holy Spirit is here. The kingdom of God is at hand, and we are called to build the beloved community. Jesus is leading the way. So as we ask, now what? Perhaps the question becomes, will we follow? Will we take the good news to our neighbors and to those labeled as strangers and outsiders and go to the end of the earth? I hope so, because that is good news that we could all use. So let's embrace this time of waiting, and let us begin again today. Today is Church Beyond the Wall Sunday. The last few years, it has been the church after Easter for us, a time to live out the good news of the resurrection, what it means to love God through loving our neighbor. In your bulletin, as well as the e-blast, you will find suggestions for projects that help us love our community and the world. I invite you to pick one or create your own, and then join us later this morning for our fellowship hour as we share our stories of being the church beyond these walls and give thanks together. So let us now go be the church, following where Jesus leads, listening for the Holy Spirit. Let us live out the good news of the resurrection and ascension. Amen. And hallelujah. Now I invite you to gather your hearts for prayer, knowing that God can hold all of our burdens, our challenges, as well as receives our moments of joy and praises of gratitude. So let us bring our prayers before our God. Will you please pray with me? Gracious and loving God, we come to you this morning feeling the warmth of your light breaking forth and awakening us to new life. We come in this Easter season with alleluias on our lips and in our hearts. We remember that what was dead shall live, what was dark shall shine, what was forgotten shall be remembered. For you are risen and walk among us. And so, God, we seek to honor you now, asking that you give us the courage to rise, to serve our neighbors, to change the world, to make impossible music, to confound systems that seek to bury and seal up that which is most tender in all of us. And so boldly we ask, O God, that you be with our neighbors, both those who are near to us and those that are far from us but near to you. We join our hearts with all who journey this day from illness to healing, and all those we know who are in need of your healing presence this week. We join our hearts with all who journey from despair to hope, from grief to consolation, from loneliness to love. May they be comforted by your peace. Oh God, we pray with compassion for all our brothers and sisters who have been hurt by hate and violence. And we ask that death may have no more power over us, for Christ is risen. And we pray for our neighbors, for this community in Polk County, for our state and our country and government, and for the world. May peace and wisdom prevail, so that in every corner of your creation, the love and well-being of our neighbor may be our concern as your hope takes hold. And God, we give thanks that your light shines in the darkness and that your love conquers hate. So may we never forget to look for your joy as we walk into this life with bold courage and hope. And now, remembering with thanksgiving the joy and power of the resurrection, the prayers that have been spoken on our lips and in our hearts, We now lift up to you, God, all that is on our heart and mind, offering out loud or in silence our prayers for ourselves, our neighbors, and your creation. O God, may you keep us in your faith, remembering the life you give us, the blessing of this community, and the love that you offer in Christ, giving to you all our prayers, our struggles, our joys, and gratitude. Said from our lips and emanating from our hearts, and those too deep for our words to express, may you intercede by the Spirit, drawing us together with your song of Alleluia as we give our greatest thanks. All this we pray in Christ's name. Amen. And now as we come to our time of offering, I invite you to reflect on the blessings that you have received this week, those ordinary moments that became extraordinary in the presence of God, the gifts of healthy relationships with friends and family and loved ones, the moments where you saw creation coming alive in beauty. Whatever it may be, let us return our thanks to God, and let us remember that when we're not sure what to believe, when we cannot fully believe what we have seen, God appears. So let us reach out to our God. Let us open our hearts. Let us give. Let us pray. You promise, Lord Jesus, to come to us in a new way, your Spirit leading us in your way. May we now rededicate ourselves to that way, giving of all we can as we are able of our time, talents, and treasure. Use us in your service, O God of promise. And let the people of God say together, Amen. Like a mother who has borne us, held us close in her delight. As we prepare now to go out into the world and begin our Church Beyond the Wall service projects, I invite you to look at some of the suggestions, as I mentioned earlier, in our e-blast or in the bulletin. There are opportunities to write cards to church members as well as those throughout our world who might need a word of hope. You can sow mass, you can pick up litter in your community, you can do something that embraces the wonders of creation, especially on this week where we celebrate Earth Day. There are many opportunities for us to love and serve our God through loving our neighbor. So let us now receive this sending and blessing as we go into the world. Let us remember that God keeps his promises. The Spirit came. And so we go now to as witnesses for God, to tell Jesus' story through our words and actions. So now, emboldened by the Spirit, let us go out into our community to serve. Amen and Alleluia.